disbelief.
Dance party, where you at, Jill Cray Duke? I want to see the Christians that come on. I got some good questions. Kenny, I'll call you when you're ready, buddy. I'm sorry. I never call my children. You'll be next. God for bless you. I'm in the world. Don't get mad, Kenny. Just pray for me. Don't yell at me. That's why I don't get married. Women will always want to know what I'm doing. Okay, here's what I want to ask you a question. Let's see who knows this. What are three of the theological virtues? Theological virtues. Anybody know? And we're gonna dance. Oh, there's my song. Who cares about the world judging me? Come on, Jack! We don't know when the world is gonna end. Start dancing! Come on, Jill! Get on the table, Jill! What's up, Hunky? Back in the days, down the decadence, Huck. Yeah, I got, thank you, Denise. Denise, I love you, Denise. Another one coming. We can dance and we learn about God. Stick around. Chum. The seven gifts of the Holy Spirit are what? The seven gifts of the Holy Spirit are what? Oh. I'll be a dreamer till the day I die. If the good die young, I'm living forever. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. And I don't go. I got dreams in my head and they won't go. I got dreams in my head and they won't go. My head and they won't go. The seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. What are they? One is wisdom. Nicole, I was talking to your boy last night. Person that'll ever hurt you in life is God. Hey, Jerry, did you go to sleep yet? I love you, G. Okay, the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. I'm full of the Holy Spirit. Everybody watching is full of the Holy Spirit. The seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. One is wisdom. Two is understanding. Three is counsel. Four is fortitude. Five is knowledge. Six is pity. Seven is number one, fear of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's all I fear in the world is Lord Jesus Christ. I don't fear nothing else. I fear God. Everybody should get this. What are the four last things that's going to affect you before you die? What are the four last things? The four last things you will face in life. What's up, Jason Hayward? Hi, Jennifer. Love you, Jen. King. Come on, Renee, start dancing, Renee. Woo! Yeah, I bet you are hungover, Jerry. Looks good on you. I love you. Now start dancing. I'm a sucker for you. Ooh, 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 ooh. Get dancing, Johnny Cloud. Jesus is watching. The four last things you're going to face in life. One is death. One is judgment. There's two more left. See, can you tell me? I hate that song. I will, Jen. The four last things you face in life. One is death. Two is judgment. Three is heaven. Four is hell. Which one do you want? You better be dancing with me. Come on, I'm the only one crazy enough to do this. No, if somebody don't answer this question, I'm going to have to start putting a load of Bible study online and get serious. What is the golden rule? What is the one golden rule in life that God says do? There's one golden rule we should all live by. I walk the fire for God. You love God. You're going to love God. I'm coming to see you, Jen. I bring the Bible. We're going to talk. Another one for Jesus. Thank you, Jennifer. Listen, I'll do some more dancing if people are after. I'm going to read some of the Bible. I don't care. God tells me to read some Bible. I just opened to this. Chapter 15, John 15. I am a true vine, and my Father is the husband bandman. Every branch in me that breed not fruit be taken away. Every branch that breed fruit, he purged it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except in it abide in the vine. No more can ye, except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. God says he is the vine and you are the branches. He that abide in me and I in him, the same bring forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. That's right, Jill. Thank you, Jill. Do unto others as they would do unto you. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, as it withers, and men gather them and cast them into fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Do you understand that, dear? Verse 7? God says, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask, and you will, and it shall be done unto you. What God is saying, if you live in God's word, and you ask God for anything, God will give it to you. God loves people that are obedient to him. God gave his only begotten son for us to die. It's very little for us to be obedient to him to receive the good things in life that we deserve. Hi, Nathan, I love you. Hi, Christina, I love you. Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit. So shall ye be my disciples. So I glorifies God. Ye know I do. Why does God answer my prayers? Because I glorifies him. He is my Father. He is my Savior. He is my doctor. He is my lawyer. He's my counsel. And that's why I'm his disciple. He picked me. He chose me. There's a lot of things beside chosen and you know, forgiven, chosen, preacher. There's a lot of different stuff. I've been chosen because I'm a good follower. I didn't learn about Jesus until he chose me. When Jesus chose me, that's when I learned about Jesus. As the Father had loved me, so I loved you. Continue you in my love. That's Jesus saying, as God has loved me, I will love you the same way. That's incredible. That God and Jesus could love us so much, and we're nothing but sinners, and we're so bad, and we get his love for free. If ye keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. That's a hard one for me, because it's hard. We can try to obey the 12, 10 commandments, but it's hard. I try to live in the 10 commandments now, because I know that's what God wants me to do. Thank you, Jason. God bless, man. I love you, Jason Lamb. Thank you, sir. God bless. And this is what it's about, sharing love and picking people up when they're doing storms. Pick people up, especially now. So many people are down. There's so many people struggling. We got to start talking to our neighbors and make sure people are not hungry and people are okay. There's people suffering in silence out there now. Depression is high. If you only saw what I went through the last couple of weeks, it was heartbreaking, some stuff I had to do, and people I prayed on, waking, having sex, I don't know. It's got to be for the grace of God. It's got to be by the grace of God that I'm not having sex. Because I have sex, but there's something in the Holy Spirit that got me that I can't have sex anymore. It's been since Christmas. That's incredible. Jesus is good. No, I'm good, Jason. Thank you. God bless. Thank you for asking, my friend. Hi, Brenda. God wants us always to be joyful. And do you know when? In my opinion, I don't think your plane has landed in loving Jesus Christ until you fear nothing and you're had no more. But some horrible things, and I got to make some horrible decisions. What is me? You know? And if anybody in Kitchener's watching this, stay away from my cousin Mary's house. I'm telling you all, don't go around her. She's a 60-year-old woman, and she's sick, and nobody better not bother her. That's all I got to say. But anyway, that's about taking care of your neighbors and being nice to people. Lift people up when people are hurting. I know there's people now that are hurting, they can't even get up and get sick, and they live on their own. It's sad. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. That's important. If you claim that you love Jesus Christ so much, and you know God is love, if you don't love everybody else around you the same way Christ do, you better start working on your church and going a bit more. Because we're not supposed to downgrade no one. We're supposed to love everybody. Christ loves everybody. So if you're going to a Christian church, a Roman Catholic church, anything, step it up or step out. Be ashamed. You got to love everybody. And that word goes, if somebody asks for your shirt, give them your coat too. That's when you know you're a pure Christian and you love God. Greater love hath no man than this, than a man lay down his life for his friends. Cray, we're going to dance after this. You still there, Jill? Hi, Lloyd. How are you? Love you, Lloyd. I love the work you do going into prisons, preaching your story, Lloyd. Thank you for... No, we're not back to work, Lloyd. No work, brother. Shut down. How many of you guys would... Greater love had no man than this. The man that lay down his life for his friends. How many people, I'll get you one. How many people would really lay down their lives for their friends? Tell me. Hold on, Lloyd, I'll get to that. Tell me, how many people would lay down their lives for their friends? Yeah, this message is from God. I'll tell you a message from God, Lloyd. The devil is the one that landed this pandemic. The devil set this pandemic on earth. God is not in a complete hurry to heal it. No, he's waking up the nations because there's so many non-believers, so many people abusing each other, so many people molesting children, so many people dying of drug addiction. God says, I'm going to sit back for a while. I'm going to shake up the nations and I'm going to shake up the weak-kneed Christians. When I get enough attention out there and the world looking at what I'm doing, that's why God shut down all the arenas, the sports events, the movie stars. God done all that, but he never released the pandemic. The devil did that, but God shut the world down to bring attention and the power of Christ. He's working on healing this now, and when it's done, it'll be a better world. But we're not here for a long time. Rapture is coming. We're all going to die soon. Only so many are going to heaven. Now let's dance. God's not allowing it. God don't allow nobody to die, Lloyd. God is a life giver. He's not a life taker. God don't allow this, my friend. No, take that up with the devil. Ask why the devil does it. How come nobody asks how come the devil does this? Nobody asked that question. I gotta dance. What's up, Jace? Come on, Jill! Woo! Lloyd, I love your questions. I'm going to talk more, but I got to dance. I'm drunk on the Holy Spirit. I'm not stripping anymore, taking me clothes off. Thank you, Jesus. I got a bit of trivia coming up for in a minute for religion.
Let me bring in John Camucci up.
I gotta ask a question first, and I'm gonna play some more music. Hang on. I see I got some really good Christians here. Okay, between everybody, tell me what the Ten Commandments are, please. What's the Ten Commandments? Come on now. I want to know the Ten Commandments. on, Jason. I think they might try to buy me out, Lloyd. I'm going to take them all to court. I already told them I'm taking Sean Bates to court. Sean Bates is a bully. Yeah, get her, Jerry. Nine more. Anybody having a hard time on drugs tonight? Let's keep it real. Anybody having a hard time on drugs? Anybody having a hard time in addictions? Anybody having a hard time in love thy mother? Honor your father and your mother. Shall not kill. Hi, Melissa. I love you, Melissa. God bless. I'm doing great, sweetheart. How are you? How's the baby? Thou shall not kill the Lord thy God. Yes, I am the Lord God. You are the shall not have the fruits. God. Yes, amen. Amen, Melissa. Come on, Melissa! Dance party in the Dodge Ram, rapping out to the Christian, whatever! God bless. I always praise for you. I met your husband. He's a beautiful man. We had a good chat in the body shop. Don't take the Lord's name in vain, baby. I am the Lord, your God. You shall not have strange gods before me. You shall not take the Lord's name in vain. Remember to keep the holy, the Lord's day. Honor your father and your mother. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery, Jason. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife. You're a snake if you go with your neighbor's wife. You're a snake. You shall not covet your neighbor's goods. Don't steal nothing on your neighbor's. Keeping everyone supplied. Okay, I got some good Christians here. What are the corporal works of mercy? The corporal works of mercy. There's seven. What's up, Robbie?
From Cold Drops.
Love you, Robbie McLean. Let's get dancing. I want everybody to dance when I get this song.
Especially our most vulnerable.
The corporal works of mercy. No gods, Jason. There's only one God. He's the Father of Jesus Christ. Holla! Yeah, Jordan, your buddy. Let's holla. Hold on, I'll get a tune. Everybody always left me hanging. Jesus Christ, don't leave me hanging. I love it! Woohoo! I need a good wife, Lloyd. I'm looking for one. I'm looking for a good wife, if anyone is out there. She's got to love Lord Jesus Christ. Dancing with her, we're all gonna get ads. You don't need drugs or alcohol, just boogie.
There are a bunch of new artists that have been added to for One World Together at Home, this big show that is...
I didn't know what the corporal works of mercy was either. Thank you, Caroline. God bless, sweetheart. I hope you're well.
Taylor Swift, I could go on.
I didn't know what the corporal works of mercy were.
It's incredible.
It's to feed the hungry. Yeah, Melissa, I love you. To give a drink to the thirsty. To clothe the naked. To shelter the homeless. To visit the sick,
so it's gonna air on CTV,
to visit the imprisoned,
MTV, and you can also listen
to bury the dead. Oh yeah, we're gonna boogie. We're gonna boogie, Jill, till the wee hours in the morning. Let's get, because I start getting a belly the last month, Jill. I'm getting fat. I don't like it. I don't. Okay. The spiritual works of mercy are, tell me after this dance, the spiritual works of mercy. I was there for you in your darkest times. Thank you, Jason. I love that, Jason. Thank you, brother. Lots of online meetings, Lloyd. I'm doing 5, 6, 7 online meetings of today, every day online. Get over you. I love Jesus. I'm there for you. There for you in your darkest times. Gotta be there for each other. You. Oh. The spiritual works of mercy. The counsel, the doubtful. To instruct the ignorant, to abomish the sinner, to comfort the sorrowful, to bear wrongs patiently, to forgive all injuries, to pray for the living and the dead. Hey, oh, Melissa, I love you, sister. Welcome, sister. Everything leads to God. make an understanding of something here right now. Listen to me. Please listen to me. I lived in drug addiction for 40 years. I did everything drug a person can do. I stabbed people. I beat people. I shot at people. I was willing to run people over. I love women. I love chasing the women. I sold drugs. God rescued me. I had lots of money. I had beautiful women. I was married to a beautiful Italian. People raised my children. I raised other people's children. The best way to live life is live through Jesus Christ. You cannot live if you don't serve Lord Jesus Christ and God my Father. You're done. Your life is going to be shite. And you can't complain about it. I'm giving it to you firsthand. The only way to live your life is with Jesus Christ. Hi, Albert. Jesus is real. Jesus is alive. And God is coming on a white horse. People don't like to talk about it. He says Christians shouldn't instill fear. Well, too bad. I had a fear instilled in me all my life. I'm telling the truth. Jesus is alive. God is coming on a white horse. And everybody's going to be left to perish. There's only so many going to heaven. I'm not going to lie, never. If people don't like it, don't tune in. I want one song. The intentions. What are the four cardinal virtues? The four cardinal virtues. I love you, Todd Sears. I love you. The four cardinal virtues. I love you, Todd. Believe it or not, I talk to God through this music. I love you, Todd. Thank you, Todd. I love you so much, Todd. Only intentions. Ye have not chosen me. Hi, Courtney. I love you, Courtney. God loves you, Courtney. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in his name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, that ye love one another. That's what I'm saying about me. Like, here it is. This is the word, right? I have not chosen God. It says God has chosen me. And he's ordained me that I should bring the word of Jesus Christ forward to everybody and work with the homeless, work with drug addicts. Bring light, tell my story, preach, and he'll answer my prayers. If I'm obedient to Jesus, that's when your prayers get answered. Your prayers can't get answered. If you think you just got to ask a prayer and then forget about God, more likely it's not going to get answered. No. God just don't answer prayers just to answer them. He really loves to answer them to people that are obedient to the love of Jesus. And you ask with conviction. You ask for a prayer knowing you're going to get it. You don't ask for a prayer thinking, oh, should I get it? Obviously you get it if you're a grateful follower of Christ. Here it is, Jim, let's go!
And a stranger.
Look what you made me do. I'm somebody new.
Oh, baby, baby,
I'm dancing with a stranger. With a stranger.
I love you, Albert. Hi, Kim. If the world hates you, you know it hated me before it hated you. If the world hates you, you know the world hated God before it hated you. If ye were of the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hath in you. It's true. It's ridiculous. You know, Melissa, I personally thank God for all the mishaps in my life. And I love for my failures. I love my time in prison. I love my time getting hurt. It made me the person who I am today. And I thank you, Jesus. I don't need nothing else from Jesus. Only a hug when I die. Amen. I don't need no material stuff. Give me a cabin with a bedroom and a toilet and a shower. And I'll live there forever. Thank you, Jesus. I want to bear fruit for Jesus. I want to bear fruit for Jesus. Powerful, Todd. Thank you, Todd. Very powerful, Todd Sears. God bless, brother. I love you, man. I love you, Todd. You're a great person. I always loved your calmness when you were a doorman. I loved how calm you were. I couldn't get it. But God made me calm. God made me calm. Lord Jesus Christ made me calm. I couldn't get it on my own. Drinking and drugs and sex. I was full of shame. My whole life. Acting cool.
/stay connect.
And I got you, Nick.
You know the coolest person in the world? Hi, Justin. Hi, Danny Price. Danny, congrats on your new position, brother. I think you're one of the best people in the world to ever run a union, Danny. Take it over, brother. Take it over. We're going to need you, Danny. Thank you for stepping up, Danny Price. I knew nobody would run against you. Who's going to run against you? It's like when God is for you, nobody's standing against you. Danny, I got so much respect for you. Hi, Justin Jordan. I love you, buddy. I'm very proud of you, Justin. Keep doing what you're doing. I love you. I might be home next week or something. If I had not done among them the works which none other man did, that had not had sin, but now they have both seen and hatred both me and my Father. But with this comes to pass that the word might be fulfilled that is written in their law, they hated me without cause. And that's God, you know. There's so many people in the world are blaming God for everything. They want to spew hate at God. And without ever mentioning the devil, nobody blames the devil for nothing. And the devil comes to seek, destroy, and kill. And the people that think God is not real, they're the ones that the devil are going to get first. The devil kind of shies away from me now because he knows, the devil knows how much God loves me and how steadfast I am in God's love. So it's hard to come against me because God will crush your head. So the devil attacks weak-kneed people that only talk to God once a month or 10 times a year or once a year when somebody dies. That's a weak-kneed Christian. God is not going to really come to you. Right, God is still stepping aside, waiting for you to come to Him. Yeah, Todd, love is so much easier. You spew out love with no energy. Like, it don't take nothing to love, but it takes so much energy to hate. Man, when I was stuck in hatred, man, like, I didn't know what to do. I hated myself. I never hated nobody. When people hate, they hate themselves. And that's the sad thing. I think some of the Christians are gone now. I'm a sinner. Let God take it out on me. I don't get drunk, I don't get high, I don't beat women, I don't rape children, I don't molest no one, I don't hit women. I'm not a bad person, and I got a good job when it's open. I want my nice song, Jill. Then I'm coming in messaging you. I got a question for you in a minute. Okay, everybody, what are the seven capital sins? The seven capital sins. Get them, Annika. Run to God if you need it. I love Jesus so much. No, I used to be a Roman Catholic. I'm a Christian, Justin. Yeah. That's from a Roman Catholic book. I like them all, though. The seven capital sins: pride, greed, lust, anger, gluttony, envy, Sloth. I like him. Tell me, Braden, brother. Good to see you, Braden. God bless Braden. I love you, man. Thank you, Braden. Let's go, Jill. Then back to more Bible. Praying for your ministry, praying for every addict in the world, and praying for healing of the nations, north, south, east, and west. Jesus, you know best. You heal it when you're ready. Coronavirus will run when we all raise a hallelujah for Jesus. I'm dancing to bring new Christians in, Braden. Bring the young kids in. Woo, Hope Dealer, I love you, Braden. Listen, guys, everybody, follow my buddy Braden Hall there. That's a good friend of my brother Mike's. You want inspiration? Follow Braden Hall. Check him out. That's my breath right quick. He ain't never seen it in a dress like this. He ain't never even been impressed like this. Probably why I got him wired on the set like this. Let's raise up children of God, not gangsters. Let's do it. Come on. Let's raise up children of Christ, not children of the devil, man. Lies, seek, deceit. It's crazy. He just wants to destroy, seek, and kill you. I love God. I don't, who cares about talking about Harold Williams? I love you all. Jesus knows I'm real. And my seed is up with God. So I don't care about dying. I just want to hear everybody crying. Let's love Jesus. Remember the word that I said unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord. If they have prosecuted me, they will also prosecute you. If they have kept my saying, that will keep yours also. But all these things will they do unto you for my name's sake, because they know not him that sent me. And that's true, man. If you think I had a hard time with the devil when I was gangster, you try to walk with Jesus Christ and watch and see how hard it is. Huh. He's tugging at your shirt tail everywhere you go. But I finally got it straight because I know there's no power greater than God. So no devil can tug at my shirt tail anymore. I stamped on his head and he's done. My heel is on his head and he'll never rise against me again. Amen, Jesus. Please, if you're struggling and in dope addiction out there, if you're hurting, please reach out to me. Reach out to somebody. Like, if you're hurting, please. I know it's getting bad out there. I was with the drug dealers this weekend. It's bad stuff happening out there, too. This is the time to get off your drugs. Do you know, I really think there's going to be a shortage of drugs, eh? Even probably later on, Suboxone, Methadone, who knows? If this goes any further, there's going to be stuff interrupted getting into the church, getting into the drugstores, getting into the drug dealers. This is a good time to get off it. If I had not come and spoken unto them, they had not had a sin, but now they have not, no cloak for their skin. He hath me, hath my Father also. If I had not done among them the works which none other man did, they had not had sin, but now they had both, seeing they hated both me and my Father. You know, and that's where I say, like, no matter what happens in the world, everybody always jumps to, why did God do this? Why did God do that? I will, Braden. I'll give Mike your love for me, brother. God bless. Have a good night, Braden. Yeah, it's hard. Everybody wants to hate God and blame everything on Jesus, blame everything on God when everything goes wrong. You hear everybody, well, Harold, if God is so powerful, why did he let this coronavirus happen? No, God never let this happen. It's the devil. It's the evil in the world. Whatever evil exists in the world got together and concocted this coronavirus. And the devil, like I tell people, the devil always goes too far. He's a trickster, he's a jokester, he's a killer. He's not out to just harm you, he's out to kill you. And he goes too far with everything, and then he leaves it all to God to fix it. But God is using this one to his advantage now to learn you. He is the way, he is the truth, he is the king. He's the only one can solve this problem. So the more you pray to God, the quicker this coronavirus will leave. Now, good night and God bless. I love you all so much, so much. I'm getting into some serious Bible study now. This 2 weeks, I put away my beginner's Bible. I gave it away. I'm breaking out my study Bible. So if there's anything you want to inbox me, I'll dig into the Bible and I'll get you the truth. The truth only comes from the Bible. So if you need it, boys, everybody, please check out my buddy Braden Hall, please. Hi, Mark Hanabury. Everybody, check out my buddy Braden Hall. You want to see an amazing story? Check it out. God bless you all. I pray for God, my heavenly. I'd like for you to heal the nations tonight. God, my Father, I'd like for you to keep protection over everybody living on the streets and dying in drug addiction. Protect them, raise them up, fill their bellies with food, nourish them from head to toe, Jesus, amen. Keep protection over everybody, the frontline workers from this coronavirus, in the name of Jesus. Please lift my buddy Braden Hall's ministry up. I know he's a powerful word and a powerful voice to all struggling kids in the world. Keep getting him to preach the word and to show his love to all the children that are suffering in this world today, Jesus. And I pray in the Jesus all of that, amen. I get excited for God. Hey, Todd. I pray for you, Sarah. Ask Braden. Sarah, ask my buddy Braden to pray for you too. Todd will pray for you. Everybody will pray for you. God, my heavenly Father, I say this prayer with conviction because I know you're going to answer it. You don't joke around when I ask this prayer, God. You made the waters part so people can walk through it. You made an ark to save animals 2x2. God, you are so powerful. You can make a mountain bend at your knees. I ask in the name of Jesus to heal Sarah from whatever she's struggling from. Pick her up and heal her, Lord Jesus Christ. God, my heavenly Father, she's your daughter. She's your daughter. You hears her cries. I can only help her, Lord Jesus Christ. I'm trying to heal her. I'm asking with your prayers, let's heal her together and lift her up and create a victory for God. And I claim healing over this. I'll claim it. In the name of Jesus, thank you for the healing. Amen. I'm a crazy Christian, man. God chose me because I tell you, nobody do the stuff I does. All right, I'm going to bed. Good night and God bless. I love you all. Hi, Kiko. Sorry, honey. You dismissed me, but God loves you. Praying for you. God bless, God bless, God bless. What's up, Lisa? Barry Sullivan! Kiko, let's dance, Kiko! Party boy! Jesus Christ, let's dance for Jesus! Christians are gonna kill me.
Every day I'm shuffling.
Every day I'm shuffling. Come on, let's go, Lise. Floor. Oh, yeah, they were bad girls. I wouldn't even go around Hurley Hard. I was scared of the girls. I love this tune. Twerk it. Let's twerk it. It's reminding me
how good it
was
when we were crazy. Why? She's spitting out the wine. Our favorite cherry red.
Reminds me of how crazy I was. I'm scared. I'm scared of Jesus. This tune. Last one. I'm going to bed. Dance it up. I'm tired. I love y'all. Thanks for tuning in.